know what these guys are going to do. The Headbangers are in action when metal continues. WWF Metal is brought to you by Vigilante 8, Second Defense, Serious Auto Combat.
And by JVC Kaboombox, so loud it hurts.
And by WWF Slam Cam. Put yourself in the action with the WWF Slam Cam. What are they wearing?
Whoa! It's scheduled for football. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 492 pounds, Boss and Crusher, the Headbangers. Their opponents, at a combined weight of 479 pounds, Duke Dalton and Knuckles Nelson.
Well, Duke Dalton and Knuckles Nelson are probably wondering what the heck is coming their way. That's Boss and Thrasher, the Headbangers, with the little number they picked out of the Dr. Tom Pritchard collection. Maybe.
I beg your pardon, I've never worn anything like that, but Thrasher looks like he has some foreign objects that he's carrying in the ring.
He's got a net on his head. He might go rob a 7-Eleven when this match is over.
Wow.
Not really. They're good-natured guys.
Yeah, right. I got another word for that.
Well, they're just a little twisted.
They're a lot twisted.
They look at things in a different point of view. And the Headbangers will join the Dudley Boys and many other tag teams. We're going to have a tag team battle royal this Sunday at Armageddon live on pay-per-view. And, Tom, there's a lot on the line. And we understand the winners of this battle royal could go to the Royal Rumble with a lot on the line.
Well, a lot on the line. The winners get a shot at the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, whoever that might be it the New Age Outlaws or the Rock and Sock Connection.
The Rock and Sock Connection certainly walk into this battle on Sunday. Maybe not thinking about the Outlaws first and foremost, but especially Mankind, you know, has got to be thinking about Al Snow.
Well, Mankind has a lot of problems with Al Snow, his former best friend, who he slided. Oh, here's a pinfall.
Backslide by Bosch. Nicely done. Duke Dalton kicks out at two.
Wow. I mean, a lot of biting comments in Mankind's book about Al Snow that Al, I think, took a lot more personal than he let on before.
Leg drop. Doesn't go for the cover. Over 75 Al Snow jokes in the number one best-selling book, Have a Nice Day.
Yeah, I mean, that there was kind of biting comments, too.
Some were funny, some, well, maybe not so funny. And maybe I think Al Snow showed Mankind that sometimes words do hurt. The written words hurt Al Snow, and then the words that Al Snow spoke this past Monday on Raw, Tom, really stung Mankind, especially the revelation that it was Al Snow that had thrown away Mankind's book.
Well, we know Al isn't exactly the most stable guy in the locker room right now. Look at this!
Isn't this how David slew Goliath?
Oh, I don't know about that. I don't think David took the foreign objects out of his wrestling apparel to slew Goliath.
That little bustier certainly coming in very handy there for a Headbanger Thrasher. All right, so let's question Al Snow's state of mind. And certainly after the war of words, then it became a physical war. In tag action Monday on Raw, and then singles action when Al Snow and Mankind went at it, these former best friends, and it seemed to be a fight that Mankind didn't want.
Well, it doesn't matter if he wanted it or not. Finally, you have to step up to the plate and fight for what you're talking about. If he's going to make all these references in his book about Al Snow and back it up, Al wanted to fight about it. He's leaving Al for The Rock.
Well, I know. Of course, Mankind enjoys being a part of the Rock and Sock Connection.
Yeah.
It's marketable. It's hip. It's catchy.
Yeah, so what? So
and
you dug your best friend over that,
well,
right?
Well, Mankind on Raw on Monday said he gave his point of view about the team of Mankind and Al Snow, that it wasn't so great.
Actually, he said it sucked.
Well, yeah, he did say that. And now look at this. With a drop down the clothesline up the second row. Great teamwork by the Headbangers, who really seem focused. They come out in bizarre attire. They do things their way, when they want, the way they want. And they're really taking it here to Knuckles Nelson and Duke Dalton.
Well, they have been successful, but again, I've got to question some of the things they wear. You know, they wear that out in public, too.
Yeah, but that's all about freedom of expression here in the World Wrestling Federation. And that only extends to our fans, but our superstars as well.
So it's freedom of expression that Mankind can write all these things about Al Snow in the book, and he's expected to just take it as a joke.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Again, you're allowed to express yourself, but again, words can have repercussions, and they certainly did for the friendship of Mankind and Al Snow. So when all was said and done Thursday on SmackDown, what we ended with was not only a broken friendship, but possibly a broken Mankind. I mean, Al Snow really gave Mankind a beating. Oh, boy, Duke Dalton in the wrong place there.
Well, Mosh is really handing it to Knuckles Nelson, probably one of the...
Is that two N's in Knuckles?
Not sure. Maybe I should read his tights.
There you go. Fans behind us here at ringside really giving Knuckles Nelson a hard time.
Man.
And it looks as if the Headbangers are giving this poor unfortunate soul a hard time as well. And I have a feeling that the Big Show is going to give the Big Boss Man a hard time. Boss Man's going to be the one doing hard time, Tom, when the World Wrestling Federation Championship is on the line this Sunday, live on pay-per-view at Armageddon.
I've got to believe that the Boss Man is really getting in the head of the Big Show. Whoa, what a stage dive!
Incredible maneuver! Oh, man, the Headbangers look great. They've got to be the favorites for the Tag Team Battle Royal this Sunday at Armageddon. The winners go to the Royal Rumble to take on the Tag Team Champions. The question is, will it be the Rocket Side Connection or will it be the New Age Outlaws? Punishment continues.
I like the viciousness in the Headbangers right now. They're not letting up.
Appears to be maybe the fun and games are over for the Headbangers as we head to Armageddon live this Sunday on...